Hi there, my name is Brodel, and this video I devoted for productivity and how we can spend our winter vacation on academic calendar more productive. And specifically, this video is devoted for things to do instead of scrolling your phone this month. What to do in this monthly vacation that we have between two semesters. And so I've gathered some useful information derived from notes I made while reading books, articles, and vlogs. So firstly, let's define the meaning of productivity itself. We tend to believe that productivity is filling our time with useful activities that help us to develop as a person, filling our time with activities that will provide us with tangible output. I really like the definition provided by Anjay the Jade and that I came across on her book, The Only Study Guide That You Will Ever Need. According to Jade, productivity is spending time well. It can be spending time with your friends, self-care, or recharging yourself. Briefly, having fun. That's the productivity. So firstly, learn new skills. Learn new skills that will definitely help you in your career path and that will have long-term effect in your personality as well. Choose the skill depending on your specialization and interests, and don't worry if it's not related to your specialization at all, and even if it fails. Because as young generation, we have more trials to make mistakes. And for example, you can learn basics of coding, digital literacy, web development, or graphic design. Or skills that will help you to be a better version of yourself and that are more handy in more places. And i.e. problem solving, creative thinking, communication skills, leadership, this project management, time management, why not? So develop small habits. If you read the book Atomic Habits, if not I recommend, you're probably aware of impact of tiny changes in our daily life.
Briefly, you develop atomic habits that are small, simple, and really easy to do, and spending for this just 2 minutes at the beginning. James Clear, author of the book, emphasizes namely the power of compound growth.
So as you see here in the screen, the graphic with time X and results Y. So if we begin developing new small habit, firstly, we'll see we are growing in this way with steady growth, whereas our growth actually happens in this way. Our growth compounds with small, these tiny changes and will have remarkable results in the long run. So by the way, this yellow part called Valley of Disappointment, where you won't see any significant results. So these small habits can be anything that you want to develop. It can be working on your appearance, beauty, body, or workout, learning new language, or improving your storytelling skills, or improving your voice, as I do to improve the quality of my videos. This method is not only related to improving working on your body, but also applicable in learning any new skill like coding, graphic design, playing the piano or the guitar, or meditating 2 minutes in the beginning. Next, we have reading books. That's the most essential habit that everyone should have, especially students, because it's widely known that it's good for our brain, it inspires us and overall makes us a better person. So try to read different books, I mean both fiction and non-fiction, and including at least one for self-development, life advice, novels, romances, and related to entrepreneurship. Personally, majority of books I read are related with this entrepreneurial stuff, and nevertheless, I'm going to reread at least 2 books of Harry Potter in this vacation, and namely in this range of closely to New Year days.
If you are not interested in reading books, start with reading books that can be interesting for you. For example, if you are keen on playing and watching football like me, you can read the books related to football. For example, Alex Ferguson, My Autobiography. In this way, you can encourage yourself to read more.
Hang out with your friends more often. So you work on yourself, read the books, develop habits, but don't forget to hang out. You'll spend your time more productively if you are having fun with your friends out there.
Also, you can encourage your friends to join this productivity journey or find other like-minded people who are willing to share own thoughts with anticipation. Moreover, hang out in places where you have never been with your friends or yourself.
So, must have explore new things for yourself. Watch documentaries, try to create something new, especially DIY. Open Pinterest, there are tons of ideas that you can do DIY to create, to boost, to increase your creativity, to reduce stress level, and it also encourages you to be more active.
By the way, documentaries are another way to gain new, deeper knowledge in certain topics that allows you to have more things to speak about and talk to people. Documentaries also introduce new world and lifestyles that you can explore and derive applicable insights for yourself. They help to broaden our outlook and keep our brain active. That's interesting.
And last but not least, work out. I'm not a person who have these six-pack abs, and even though I think we have to work out because we are human creatures, we should exercise in order to lead more healthier and happier lifestyle. If it's too hard to start exercising, start with small. Start with 5 minutes, start with 2 minutes. I raised from 10 to 20 minutes in the last 3 or 4 months, and even though I do it every 3 days, not every day. And consistency is the key here, and I'm sure that it will show incredible results in the long run.
It also directly positively influences on how our brain works and cognitive functions, helps us to reduce body fat, build lean muscle mass, boost our flexibility, improve our posture, stability, boost metabolism, and make weight loss easier.
So this video was made for students who are willing to work on themselves. And last thing I would give from my own experience, don't overthink on what you are going to do. Instead of working on yourself hard, try another approach. Work efficiently and spending less energy and less time. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.